Hey, happy holidays. This is Jackie Brawls.
Ho, ho, ho.
It's not Christmas, New Year's now, but that's, I call Christmas week from Christmas on to New Year's, and I hope all y'all had a good Christmas and got everything you want Santa to bring you and all that. What are you getting into over there?
Huh?
What are you getting into? What is that?
Somebody give me a Starbucks Cranberry Bliss bar.
What?
Christmas, I thought. Got so much Christmas goodies, I call it. All these Christmas goodies.
Yeah.
You can't eat them all during Christmas. You just be in the bathroom the whole time.
Hey.
So I like to eat some of them after Christmas.
Well, they last year. If you got people, like they bring food over to me and Miss Brawls, women from up down the street, and some women, I don't know where they come from, bring food all the time over every Christmas. And there ain't no way she barely eats anything outside of like Campbell's soup, you know, baby, not baby food, but, you know, soft. You have to be soft. So half the stuff she can't even eat, and it's going to go bad. If I said, hang on, I got some of these. Somebody brought 2 pounds of these. It's cold as Christmas. 2014. Hang on. And it's good. It's every year they do Coley's Christmas mix. They do it a little different. Add a little extra something. I think this year they, what is it? There's something red. Sweet red though. Anyway. Hey, you want some of
that? Yeah, sure. Let me get you some of that Cranberry Bliss bar.
It's from Starbucks. I probably don't like it.
No, it's good. Better than you think. Oh, I taste the little eggnog flakes.
Yeah.
And the peppermint spirals are good this year.
I ain't got no fork. It's going to get all over my fingers.
I brought some paper towels.
Well, I need something to wipe my fingers. Hang on, let me put this.
It ain't bad, is it?
It's got a tart to it. Tart something.
Yeah, it's a little tart. It's got cranberries.
I still had some Coley's Christmas mix in my mouth when I'm.
Yeah.
So I don't know if I got the full. Hang on. I'm going to swallow everything. Drink some of this water. Ah. All right, let me see. Well, that's too. That's,
you don't like it?
It's too tart for me.
I like these peppermint spirals in here. I guess that's the eggnog flakes, peppermint spirals, and what'd you say, the sweetbread chunks?
Whatever is red in there, I don't know.
Oh, sweet red chunks. Well, that's the podcast for this week, folks.
Oh. Yeah, we hope you had a good holiday.
Oh, wait a minute.
What?
I have some of these left over. Peppermint Oreos. So yeah,
peppermint Oreos.
Seasonal, limited edition. Look here, Jackie. Remember how you used to, you get a pack of Oreos, you had to try to, how I open this. Now look here.
Yeah.
You remember how bad it used to be.
Well, you just pull on the tab now.
Yeah.
Like a parachute or something, just pull the tab down.
Uh-huh. And there's a hole in the package where you put your hand in it and get your Oreo.
Get 4 or 5 of them instead of just 1 or 2. Yeah, let me try. What's it got red in it, though? Everything got to have red with Christmas.
Well, it's peppermint, see?
I just like cream. The white on the, just the old Oreo where you take the top, you know, whatever they say, twist it, break it, eat it, how. Now, see, this tastes like one of them hotel mints put on the pillow.
Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I just want regular. I don't like chocolate.
You don't like a goddamn peppermint patty?
I never did care for it that much.
York peppermint patty.
I remember. I never cared for that.
So those were the snacks. We Coley's Christmas mix. We had a bunch left over. Jackie got 2 pounds of it.
I'd say I got some dressing. I mean, most of it, that's something somebody bought. Not be easy to get rid of, but most of them just wrapped up dishes. I can't eat all that on my own.
You give it to the homeless.
Well, if I put it out in a dumpster out back, they're going to get it either way.
That's how I feel about my recycling. Somebody will find that bottle.
Oh, hell yeah. You put your plastic wherever you want to put it. They're going to get into it if it's in trash, which I don't know where else you're going to put all that
like
stuff.
A raccoon, but if a raccoon, took their cans in to get money.
Well, they need that to eat and everything else. So I just...
Raccoons eat...
Not
fish,
raccoons. You talk about homeless people.
Oh, yeah, they do. They need it.
I'm talking about homeless people and the... If I can take it down in a shelter or wherever that is, I don't know, somewhere in town. Or I can just, like I said, if I just take it back there by the dumpster, just set it back there at the...
They'll get it.
Yeah. Well, not leave it in the... I dump it out on something. I don't... Because you got to return the dish to them. They'll be back next week. And I say, yeah, I ate all that. It was good. Was that it? What?
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying the Red State Update podcast so far. First, we wanted to talk about Christmas leftovers. I think we've done that.
Well, we're going to eat some is what we're doing. Yeah, we got all sorts of... There's some stuff up top, too, upstairs. I'll show you when we get done.
You got any of that ham left?
Yeah, it's pretty much all fatty now. Everybody made a sandwich out of it or something else. But it's pretty much just all down to the fat on it.
What about the turkey?
We didn't have no turkey this year.
Nobody brought ham?
They brought a big ham, yeah. I don't want both, or just, one of the others is fine. I don't need to eat,
I got a mouthful. It's Coley's Christmas mix. I got all peppermint spirals.
Wait, it's a mix. You're supposed to shake a bag.
It's too much.
Well, you shake a bag a little bit before you up.
Oh, it says here on the bag, Coley's Christmas mix. Mix it yourself.
Oh, do me a favor. Reach down there. I ain't got the Bible page out of that one yet.
Oh.
I just want to see if we got the Christmas story. I think that's the contest nowadays if you get the, Christmas story out of the Bible.
You win a trip to Bermuda.
Is it? It ain't Bermuda, is it? Mm-hmm. Is that where the...
These 2-pound bags, you can get your arm way up in here.
Yeah. Just got to feel around in there. Plus, when you're also mixing it all up, too, you won't get a mouthful of spirals. Every time you reach down for the Bible page, which you need to do anyways... Everybody needs to reach. If more people reach for the Bible, a page or the whole thing, it'd be a better world. So you're doing that, plus you're mixing up everything in there. You ain't going to get a mouth of just the peppermint spice.
All right, here we go. Let's see if we won that trip. Jackie, you and me may be. It's time next week, lounging on the sand, reading a Bible page in Bermuda.
I sell that. I ain't going to Bermuda. Hell, I sell that vacation to somebody.
Corinthians.
Yeah. Don't throw it. Save it. Just because it ain't the baby Jesus story, you don't wad it up, throw it away. Corinthians is good, too. You just don't win a contest. You still win if you get that. So,
what do you win?
Just, I ain't going to do it on this here. I may do my own parkish down the road.
Podcast.
Where I'll reach in, I'll either have a Bible or eat and get the pages out and I'll read it on here. I ain't got time for that now. But you'll see what I mean. You put your nose in the good book or...
Ain't got time for Jesus.
Well, wipe the crumbs off of that instead of throwing it away and then see what you think. Read it and see what you think. You may, your attitude may change.
I'll put it out back for the homeless.
Well, no, Lord knows I can use it in hell. Well, do you have a good holiday, I hope?
Yeah, pretty good holiday. I'd say it's one of the better Christmases.
I don't want to hear nothing filthy. I just ask you if it was good or not. That's it. I don't need to know what you did. Just leave it at that.
Well, Granny didn't take a church trip or anything this year. She stayed at home.
I was also wasn't just asking you, just asking everybody out there. I know they can't answer, but just hopefully they all nod their head yes.
Mama got off work from J.C. Penney, and she come over to Granny's, and her new husband was there. Me and him got along pretty good.
Oh, excuse me.
You okay?
Now, just that peppermint don't sit.
Peppermint is
just too much overload. You got the spires in one, and you got the Oreo supposed to be white, but it's red.
Peppermint is supposed to settle your stomach.
Well, it ain't doing that for me.
I'm trying to tell you about what a nice Christmas we had. Everybody getting along.
So far, everything you see, it's fine. I don't. When it gets to something I don't want to hear, I say thank you very much, and we'll move on.
We had a turkey.
Well, yeah.
Mom made some dressing.
We had ham. Still got some upstairs. A little, mostly fat, but now, but.
Then Daddy come by. He was just at the right stage in between church and drunk to where he was enjoyable.
Well, that's good. Him. Mama said she wasn't ever going to have more anymore last time I talked to her, babe.
Well, it's Christmas.
Well, that's true. Holidays for you.
Him and Mama's new husband got along pretty good.
Well, that's good. That's good to know.
And Granny was just happy with everybody being over there.
Good for her.
I went into the bathroom and jerked off.
All right, that's it. Enough. I don't want to hear it anymore. You just knew you had to ruin everything. You just had to run your mouth. Act smart. I don't want to hear it.
It was just like, though, Jackie, Christmas is about childhood memories. It's all it's about. And I remember as a kid, you'd always, after big Christmas dinner, you'd go sneak off in the bathroom to jerk off.
All right. I don't want to hear it.
You had to do it fast.
Glad you had good Christmas when you was young. Fine. That's good. I don't want to hear about it. I don't.
Reminded me of it so much, I did it real fast so nobody gets suspicious.
Enough. I don't
want. And then I come out and everybody was, hey, Dunlap, you back? I'm like, I am. Relaxed. Ready to socialize.
Just enough. I don't care anything about that.
It was like
nobody else wants to hear it either. I'm telling you right now.
It was like I had just looked at a Sears wish book.
Oh.
In 1983.
Sears.
And it just flashed me back. Happy candy cane colored memories.
I don't want to hear about it.
I hope you had a good Christmas.
I had the same Christmas I always have. Me and Miss Boyle sat there. We watched some of Christmas movies, old movies. I can't remember the names of all of them, but we watched Bing Crosby sing White Christmas, that one in there.
I think that's called Snow on the Lake.
Snow on the Lake, whatever it was, he's in a hotel. But, you know, it.
Then Henry Fonda and Angel Comes Down, you never was alive.
I remember that. I watched that last. That comes on almost beginning of December. I saw that one a while back where his ears messed up. And I hate Christmas. Angel come down and he tells him, yeah, never were alive. That's what happened. But this one, it wasn't nothing like that. I mean, it was just as silly in a way, but didn't really have no point to it. They just singing and dancing, you know, with a Christmas tree up. He sang White Christmas. I like it. You know, I've heard that for years. That's about it. But it was on, you know. I'd probably seen it before. Didn't remember it, but I ain't much to remember to begin with. I miss Grinch's. Didn't see that this year. I usually try to watch Grinch, and I don't like him, but that's the only thing he's in that I could, because, you know, he's supposed to be acting crazy for a change, because he's a monster. Hates Christmas.
Now you're talking about Jim Carrey in the Grinch.
That's the only thing I tolerate watching him. It's funny because of the way they look. You know, and if he looked like that in every movie or whatever, I might go see it. But I don't care for him most time. But I missed Grinch this year. I usually like to watch that. Everybody got funny nose. in Christmas Town. But we had, you know, like I said, all the neighbors come by and they put the, give us some food, you know, and you got to be kind of, like I already got a table and a half full in there, just, you know, but you got to be polite, you know, we have to accept, you know.
Did you get that food I left you?
You didn't leave no damn food.
I did.
No, you did not.
Did you not see that zero bar on the table?
What?
Somebody give me a zero bar. They said, this fell out of the vending machine by mistake. I hit the wrong button. I ain't never going to eat this.
Well, if it's on table, it's underneath everything else. I didn't see it on there.
I ain't going to turn down a free candy bar, but I don't know, zero. So I was like, well, what am I going to do with this? I thought, I'll just go, when I go over to Jackie's to borrow his copy of The Grinch, I will put this zero bar on the table, and him and his wife can enjoy it.
Excuse me.
What is the matter with you?
Too much of that peppermint got in there.
Jackie, what if the podcast awards committee is listening to this one? Now, look at the strikes we got against us. Supposedly political podcast, but we never talk about the news. Our grating southern accents. I just talked about jacking off.
That's the part. You
then they get to you belching and burping.
They don't want to hear the filth come out of your mouth. If I don't sit on here ever, if they listen to more than one, which I don't know why they would, they ain't going to hear belching on every one of them. They're just going to hear you talking about going in the bathroom, playing with your thing. Christmas, Easter, Halloween, don't matter what holiday it is.
Well, it doesn't
That's all
matter.
They're going to hear of you, and nobody wants to hear that. I get sick because you give me all that peppermint. It's the only time you're going to hear on there me belching or passing. You know, you won't hear it. Maybe on one where we had a few drinks. Yeah, maybe. But every one of these ever did, you's in the bathroom playing with your thing. And you think that's what people want to hear out there.
Pitiful. I think an exploration of human sexuality is definitely deserving of some sort of podcast award. What I don't think is deserving of a podcast award is an old man sitting there, burp, burp, burp. That is...
I said, excuse me,
unclassy.
I don't sit here and do that all the time, and you know I don't, whereas you, on every time you hit go on the computer, you just ready to talk about playing with your thing.
I don't know how podcast awards committees listen to podcasts. I don't know how they figure out which episodes are the ones they want to judge. I'm just saying, this is it. If this is the one they listen to, Jackie, you just shot ourselves in the foot.
Oh, hell, I come on doing that long after you talk about grabbing yourself or whatever. I don't, there ain't no comparison as far as I'm concerned. You be mad at your own self. Not just for being embarrassed for anybody hearing that, but if whatever committee, awards, city, whatever it is, they heard they done turned it off long before I ever had the belt. And if they were listening, I'm sure maybe one of them at one time or another ate too much peppermint, same thing happened to them. You know, it could be something like, well, he's human. I've been there. I know what that's like, you know. Could be like that. He don't judge like you do right off the gate.
Well, you're right, Jackie. Podcasts are about discovering the bridges of commonality that bring all human, the human experience.
I know. Well,
we all got that.
We all hate Obama. Every one of us most, you know, there's a few idiots out there, but.
Probably they're all on the podcast awards committee.
Well,
if we ever want to win a podcast award, I think we're probably going to have to stop hating Obama. You know those societies that give out awards. They're all liberal, Jackie. They all love Obama.
I don't care for no award. I ain't trying to get no award. I talk about what I want to talk about. I ain't going to talk anything good about Obama. I'd sit here and lie on here to get something to put on the wall. I don't know.
if we start talking about how great Obama is, if we change the name of this to the Obama's Great Podcast.
Oh, hell.
I think then we'd get more listeners, because I have a feeling that podcast listeners are all snooty, stuck-up liberals who love Obama.
Then what the hell are we doing this for?
I don't know. It's like we're just banging our heads against the wall. Every week. Bam, bam, bam.
I agree with you there, yeah.
So that's our Christmas update, folks. We talked about the food. We talked about what we did at Christmas. We talked about podcast awards. Christmas update, that was the first segment on this week's episode 112.
Yeah.
Red State Update podcast.
Excuse me. Hell. Peppermint, too much of it. Can't.
Now it's sponsor time. Sponsor time here on the Red State Update podcast. That's segment two. We did the small talk that was about Christmas snacks. Jackie decided to belch.
I didn't decide. I can't.
He's 8 years old and thinks that's funny.
I don't think it's funny. I can't help it. I said, excuse me. You think going in the other room and grabbing yourself is funny? Don't.
That's what everybody does it. Everybody does it.
I don't want to have to hear about it.
Everybody can relate to it. But I'm not doing it on the podcast.
Now, you better not.
Get on here and talk about indigestion, belping, birching, belching, burping, all those ones. Do it. Talk about it. You write a little fucking TED Talk about
burping. Watch your mouth.
Whatever. Get on the moth and tell your belching story.
Enough.
But I talk a lot about masturbation.
Okay, I don't want to hear about it though. I don't.
But
think
am I doing it?
No, and
on
you
the
better
podcast?
You better not either. And I don't sit around and belch on here every week. I don't do it. I ate too much of that peppermint. Something wrong. I got indigestion. I can leave. You can sit here and do it by yourself. If that's what you want to do, I'm happy to do that. I'll get up out of here as soon as I do my sponsor. I get up and walk on out of here. And I'll belch upstairs.
I promise to be able to hear you.
Well,
you know how old people so loud.
Oh, hell. Let me do.
Saying it ain't funny.
They gave me $25. I'm going to sit here and just do the sponsor, and then you see what you decide what you want to do then. See, I pretty much know you're just going to talk about the same thing over and over again. Been doing it for how long? Was it 100?
112.
Touch yourself. Proper conversation. My sponsor this a week right after Christmas. It's still Christmas theme. It's still the holidays. And if you got any thing in mind to do on New Year's Eve, you need to just forget it right now. And I'm going to tell you where to go. Now, Murfreesboro Play Action Club this time of year, they always do Tuna Christmas with, you know, with the show with two of them up acting idiots all the way through. Well, they're doing that like I do every year, but on one night only is going to be playing the two idiots. You know, I don't mean it's supposed to be idiots. I ain't calling the people unless they're funny that way. You know, it's what it is.
That's a costume change. Play a lot of different characters.
Yeah. But there's only two of them acting like the different idiots is what I'm saying on the stage.
Sure.
I saw it years ago, but so I don't need to see it again. But I am going to see it. I tell you right now, I'm going to see it come New Year's Eve. Because, number one, all of it going to charity. Every ticket they sell in a standing room only in there, they're going to open it up to more people. They went and talked to the fire department, and they agreement just for that night, you know.
You give us tickets, said the fire department, and y'all can do whatever you want.
Well, they're going to have more people than they normally have in there because they're going to have to see them. And all this money is going to a good cause, going to a charity. Now, let me tell you who it's going to be doing the Tuna Christmas. It's old member Bill Barinut.
Oh, yeah.
And he's also going to be down at Muslim's department store up until New Year's Eve, going to leave the store right after they close the doors, going to go all the way. They're going to follow him over there, and he's going to go up on stage with old Bill Barinut, and that's the talking Christmas gift. and they're going to do the whole tuna. And it's, they, yeah.
So Bill Berrynut, Murfreesboro media legend, no yep. one really cares for.
He's all right.
A jewelry store owner, yeah. owns a jewelry store. And the talking Christmas gift, who have not, as far as I know, not appeared together since, what was that, early 90s when they did Berrynut on Buffets?
Oh, yeah, I remember that. It did. They did like, it was just like a, what do you call, a miniseries. It didn't, they only did so many of them.
Right, that was old. Then for local cable here, it was basically Bill Berrynut would just travel around different buffets here in Murfreesboro and just take pictures of them. He might talk to some people eating at the buffet and people bringing out the food. Might talk to some of the people who own the buffet.
Oh, that's fine, but people watched it because of a Christmas gift, playing with the children in the restaurants, you know, where the buffets, well, he played with the children and talked to people. More people were more interested. And come to find out, they made a good team because you go back and forth. When that talking Christmas gift comes in, everybody leaves a buffet. They go over to look at the talking Christmas gift, and then old Bill Berrynut had enough time to go up to the buffet by himself and talk about what's in there and what the food is.
Scallops?
Yeah.
So
he was almost like a diversion, but still, it was funny. You know, you'd see him talk about the food, and if you like that sort of thing, you know, I learned a couple of new buffets opened I didn't know about from looking at that years ago.
But mostly, it was just like if you like looking at pictures of buffets. So, because here, I would always get surprised every two or three weeks. I'd be like, well, that's a new one. I didn't know that buffet opened. But mostly, it was just like, oh, I've been to that buffet, and now I get to look at it. And it worked because a lot of times I'd be like, oh, I want to go get some scallops.
It's just like a McDonald's commercial and anything else. Like, I ain't had one of them in a while. You go on down there, you know.
Yeah, and it was old Clay Sunday produced it, you know, who helped Mr. Leakey commercial.
I don't know if he helped him. He was working on it and got, yeah, money's owed, something like that. I don't have anything to do with that. I'm out of it.
I think that's where Clay Sunday got his start, making local buffet commercials and television series. But it was the same thing when Bill Berrynut had, what was that, Berrynut on the Burrow, or Burrow Nut?
Yeah.
And then he got hurt, and then he got sick or twisted his ankle.
Something he couldn't. Yeah, he was bedridden for week longer. Yeah, I can't remember how long.
Guest host, and the one that really took off was Talking Christmas.
Yeah, ratings went through the roof on that. Everybody wanted to watch that.
So they were going to give Talking Christmas gift his own program, let him take over. They couldn't work out a deal or something. So
something with mushrooms, they own the property. Owned whatever that Christmas gift is, character, I don't know, talking Christmas gift. But
but when they got together to do the Berrynut on buffets, you know, Bill Berrynut would not allow talking, because it really should have been talking Christmas gift on buffets.
Yeah.
But Bill Berrynut would not allow that. But that's why it said Berrynut on buffets, but the picture was always talking Christmas gift.
Yeah. And he's funny. You know, that's funny to see. You know, what's in me? You know, he'd asking all the people in the, what you eating there, whatever, and what's in me, you know?
So I wouldn't say they had chemistry, but they have done something together a long time ago.
Well, I mean, everybody associates them together for different reasons. Like you said, he come in and was on the show, took over for him when he hurt himself. Excuse me. Good God. Something wrong. And then he, years later, they did the buffet show. But what they're doing now is it's for a good cause, too. Get your ticket. It's probably going to be a little pricier than it normally is.
For charity.
That's the reason why. It ain't
charity,
just for them.
Always expensive.
I tell you, most people pay a lot more than what they're charging just to see old Bill Berrynut and talking Christmas gift together. But it bring back memories. But it's going to be a fun night, and all the money, like I said, is going to cherish all, every cent, every dime. They said Murfreesboro, you know, was non-profit. They already took care of themselves this year at the end of the year, and every dime from this one-time performance on New Year's Eve, all that money, every cent they guaranteed, is going to help all them hurt dogs.
Well, hurt dog. What hurt dogs?
Oh, remember all the hurt dogs in the lot. You know what I'm. It was in the lot behind.
Oh, behind Seafood and Lobster.
Behind Seafood and Lobsters.
That
all
field
them hurt dogs.
Out there, that, yeah. Yeah, that empty lot. All them hurt dogs. That's, yeah, I don't like driving by there.
No, well, nobody does, yeah. Well, I mean, that's we're going to fix it. You know, we're going to get all that money together. All them dogs, all them hurt dogs, hopefully going to be taken care of. You got enough money, yeah.
Well, that is a good cause. And who doesn't like to see Tuna Christmas? I can't imagine talking Christmas gift, getting in all them costumes and saying, what's in me? What's in me?
Yeah, it's going to be something to see. Like I said,
Christmas.
I've already seen it. And like you say, one time you pretty much know what you're in store for. But it's going to be, that's going to bring a whole new, you know, just well, them two in it. It's going to be something to see, yeah.
It's a reunion of people who never really got along that well and are chemistry-less. But, you know, it was about 20 years ago last time they were together, so that qualifies as nostalgia. So get your tickets to Bill Berry Nut and the Talking Christmas Gift.
One night only, New Year's Eve, Murfreesboro Play Actors Club. You better get your ticket right now, I tell you, because it's going to be, like I said, talk to the fire department. They said, go on, let them bring, you know, as many as you fit in there, get them in there. If the money's going where you say it's going, we're with that, you know.
I hope they take a little break. I hope they break the fourth wall a little bit and Talking Christmas Gift comes out and starts asking the audience, what's in me?
Oh, you know he's going to. He does that. That's what he does. If they go with the whole night and he don't ask anybody what's in me, then people are going to be disappointed. Reading, I got my ticket. You know he's going to do what he does. That's what Talk Christmas Gift does.
Bill Berry Nut's weird, though. He's not what I'd call funny.
Well, no, he just, you know.
Or someone who could hold the attention of an audience despite numerous television radio programs.
It don't matter. Either way, it's going to be funny looking at him with a different mustache on in a dress, whatever. And he'll be sitting next to Talking Christmas Gift.
I hope they do. I hope I mention like buffet, like a little end joke, like, well, let's go to the buffet.
They're going to be something like that. But they're also serving, you know, New Year's Eve, as soon as the show's over, they're going to stand around. You can talk to them, tell them what a good job. Try to guess what's inside,
sure.
You know, Talking Christmas Gift. And they're going to have, the champagne, all that stuff. And when it strikes midnight, bring in the new year. Can't think of a better way to do it.
Oh, maybe champagne is what's in the Talking Christmas Gift.
That may be what's in store. I don't, you know, I'm going to go find out. I don't know what's in him. You know, if he asks me in the middle of a show, I'm going to say, I don't know, you know.
That's all you really can say. Don't try to be smart.
Oh, if you try to be clever with him, he'll get you. He'll make you the show, the butt of all the jokes. So I'm just going to be honest, just right after. I don't know.
So that's Murfreesboro Play Actors Club presents Tuna Christmas charity show, New Year's Eve, starring Bill Berry Nut and the Talking Christmas Gift. That's a good sponsor, Jackie. You did a good job on
that. Well, like I said, money's going to a good place, and going to be a good show.
I got a sponsor this week, Jackie. I think you're not going to like it. It's sad. It's a sad sponsor. I couldn't even take any money from them, it being Christmas and all. They just wanted to get on here and say thanks to everybody for doing all they could, but unfortunately it was time to close the doors and move on. Man. We've lost another small business here in Murfreesboro.
Oh,
God bless the small business person, Jackie, because it is hard as hell out there.
I blame Obama. I don't even know who it is. My heart's going out to him already.
Well, you know Kelly and Carter Tepper that run the Christmas Cottage incinerator in the back. They've been
they're going out of business.
They said, look, they knew there was a thin profit of margin in burning up Christmas trees. They knew it would mainly be after Christmas.
Well, yeah, that's...
But they didn't know that the rest of the year there would be, like, no Christmas trees. And so it's just hard to turn a profit. It's hard to keep the doors open when you're that constrained
when your budget is that constrained, you just can't do it. Well, you got kids to feed and everything, and they wanted to thank you.
Why are they going out of business right now? That don't make any sense. It's a business. In between now and next week, and then the week after that, it's a big business time. If you're going to close down,
I know it.
Well, just wait till then. At least you're going to close that, you know.
Times are hard, Jackie. They could not stay open one more day.
But this is when everybody goes there. The trees are dying right now.
Screw it. Oh. We tried everything we could. They tried getting people to buy extra Christmas trees and bring them down there. They tried getting people to bring the Christmas toys down there to burn up because they were legally allowed to burn up Christmas toys. They tried to get get people mad at the fictional meanest boy in town and buy a toy that was supposed to represent his present.
Burn it.
Burn it.
Yep.
Did not happen. They could not get the permits required to just burn regular garbage or
that's
even
what,
Christmas
city
garbage.
Ordinance, is that what it is? They can't burn garbage? Because if you just had a place, because it would save people a lot of time. It wouldn't have to drive so far out. If you just drive up to Christmas College, they burn garbage. And I don't make any sense to me, because if the city lets them burn toys, it's the same thing as burning garbage. I mean, what's the difference?
They went down to the courthouse. This is a sad part. They went down to the courthouse and they talked to some Mayor Bane Jekyll's people. And they said, could we possibly just burn Christmas garbage? I mean, is that something that's illegal for us to do? And they said, oh, you know what? Why don't you come back like December 29th and we'll talk about it then. But I don't see a problem with it. We just have to sign some paperwork and get things going. But that probably just take couple hours in the afternoon. Come back on the 29th. We'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
But you know, bad timing, man. They just could not. What is today?
What is today? I don't.
December 28th. See, it's just timing is terrible. Timing is just terrible. And you know, it is hard for a small business.
But they can still burn Christmas trees. They can burn, if they just stay open, at least you go out with a little cushion underneath you. You got between now and next week and the week after.
They've already started dismantling.
That's two weeks of just, you know, money coming in hand over fist.
The Christmas Cottage trailer. They took an axe to it, and they are doing free burnings where they're just burning that trailer up.
Free? But they get it.
Well, that's right, folks. Christmas mix. Sad, Jackie. It's sad whenever anybody loses a business. And I guess you, the expert on the tree burning business, could have told them all this months ago.
They didn't ask me. I ain't like someone to walk in somebody's business and tell them how to run it. I ain't Obama or anybody else like it.
Oh, it's so easy to run a small business.
I didn't say it was.
Tell everybody how to run their small business.
I have run one most of my adult life, but it ain't easy. I never said it was easy. I never said no such thing. Bless their hearts, I don't want them to close up, but if you got to close up, do it in 2 weeks, and at least you're going to go with a little more money, because everybody goes down there and burns a tree after Christmas. I mean, that's the busiest time of the year.
2 more weeks, man. 2 more weeks. Can't you just stay they don't have another 2 more weeks in them, Jackie. They ain't got it.
I don't understand. I'm sorry. I know. I blame all.
Take your Christmas. They've already had this happen. They are trying to close up and leave town, demolish their Christmas Cottage trailer, and burn it in the incinerator. And people keep showing up. Folks, Kelly and Carter Tepper have just lost everything. Their business, their home that they're destroying. Mm. They're getting ready to leave town. Everything they've got left, just throw it in a truck and the kids. And people keep showing up. The hardest time that Kelly Carter Tepper probably ever gonna go through with a goddamn Christmas tree in the back of the truck. Say, hey, can we burn this? Like, why are you trying to put your problems on Kelly Carter Tepper?
That's
you got a Christmas tree, take it to the dump.
They ain't asking them to do it for free. They go down there and pay a fee to get it done. It ain't like do us a favor. They will make money if they just stay open 2 more weeks. If they can't, they can't. I'm sorry. I still blame Obama. Small businessmen can't come.
Oh, yeah. It's Obama's fault.
Well, it is because, small businessmen can't do anything nowadays. And plus, all that, Earth Day, all that mess.
That did not help.
Because you can't burn the trash, in town. Used to be you could burn trash anywhere.
You walk outside with a sack of garbage. I'm talking egg cartons, plastic milk jugs, wax paper milk jugs.
My garbage, my fire.
And you just take it out in the middle of the yard, throw it on the ground, kick it around, and set fire to like every little piece of that garbage that exploded out of it when you put boot to it.
Yeah.
That was fun. The worst thing about Obama is we don't get to burn garbage anymore.
Oh, that's where it begins. Starts there. You ain't going to be able to do a lot of things here pretty soon.
So don't bring your Christmas tree down to Kelly and Carter Tapper's Christmas Cottage. That's sort of salt in the wounds, folks.
I don't know where they're going to take it.
They showed up there this morning and because they had the gates closed. And there was about 5 or 6 Christmas trees just sitting out there in right outside the gate.
Did they leave money with it, though? Did they leave money with it? It ain't like somebody that, or I owe you or something.
They left money with it. So Kelly and Carter Tepper had to burn those trees free of charge and then return all the money to these inconsiderate assholes.
Hey, why would they?
That's why they had to drive all over town. Here's your check. Thanks. Thanks for pinning this to the gate.
Why the hell did
that? I had to come over here and give it back to you. I'm trying to dismantle my life so that I can go on the road with my wife and children, who we will have to homeschool, but without being able to afford any sort of program. We're just going to have to make it all up on our own. So they're going to be idiots.
No reason to give them money back, because if you...
So that's the Christmas cottage. Sad story. I hate hearing.
Why did they give you $25 to say all this?
That they offered it to me, but I said in the spirit of Christmas, I cannot take this $25.
Well,
I took $15.
What?
And I said, but they God bless you.
Why do they want to tell people that are they trying to blame people? I don't understand.
They just wanted to say 2 things. Thanks to everybody who tried to help them out.
Well,
all the different plans that never worked. And don't bring your Christmas tree down there. It's too late.
I don't know why they would
say that. Basic message is it's too late.
They get run off of land, that's one thing, but I don't understand it.
So that's Christmas Cottage. No more.
Hey, look at there. You see him? Well, open your damn eyes then. It's the old-timey country down-home Red State Update podcast and them. Coming to you from a bunker underneath Jackie's Market in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And here they are, both of them.
Hey, it's Jackie Bro.
Folks, my name's Dunlap.
Yeah. Well, you want to say something else? That's it.
No, that's it.
Seemed like you was ready to talk some filth like you normally do.
No. I was just telling people who I was so they'd know whose voice they were hearing.
I think ain't nobody now, but anyway.
There's always a new listener.
I think we got the same amount every one of these, ain't
it? Well, some of those are people who just give up on us.
Oh, yeah.
They go away. Then we get a new listener. Like
somebody comes in and replace them. You just kind of go filter through them. They get tired of listening to it after a while, and then get the next one. Now, that makes sense. I understand that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, it's holiday season again.
Christmas time.
Dunlap.
New Year's.
And I believe it was last year you let me put on... You didn't let me. I made you let me play my favorite old Christmas tradition song albums, Conway Twitty's Merry Twistmas, when they him and the Twitty Bird go see Santa Claus. And so many of y'all, I was surprised that so many had not heard of that particular record that means so much to me for so many years, holiday albums. And y'all said to me when on the emails that Dunlap shows me and the other ones I seen on computers that, Jackie, we thank you so much. We listen to that now, and it's a tradition in our house. So that's something being passed on, you know, something to go keep going down history every Christmas. And they said if you know any other Christmas album, songs, anything, you know anything as good as this Merry Twistmas, we sure would like to hear that. So you found him on the computer for me over here. He said he's going to set it. Well, we can listen to it. These are two of my favorite. It's old. Everybody loves Tennessee Ernie Ford, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Tennessee, everybody loves Tennessee Ernie.
He's one of the best. He, you know, that's the reason everybody recognizes his name and knows his work, because he's one of the best
ever. You can walk into any elementary school, college campus, and say, hey, who here likes Tennessee Ernie Ford? And you're going to get 98, 99% of the people. And the ones that don't, just not to their taste.
Well, I see you trying
Everybody knows who he is. I'll guarantee you that.
Well, you trying to be smart, but maybe now the people will know who he is, because people, after they hear him on here, next Christmas comes around, they'll be playing it for their youngins and so on and so on. So hopefully that will be the case here soon. And I mean, but people with any, you know, taste ought to know who he is. You know, if you like music, you like Tennessee Ernie Ford. That's all there is to it.
If you like music, folks, you like Tennessee Ernie Ford.
Yep.
And Jackie has made me let him play two songs.
Yep.
Tennessee Ernie Ford Christmas songs that I'd never heard of before. Maybe y'all have. Jackie loves them.
Yeah, Klinker, Jingle-O.
Jingle-O, the brownie.
Yeah. That's one of them, yeah.
And Little Klinker.
It sounds like it could be one song, I'll be honest.
Jingle-O, the Christmas brownie, and
Klinker,
Little Klinker, the pup that woke Santa up.
Yeah. Santa Claus trying to sleep. Yeah, I don't want to ruin it for you.
Give it away.
I'm not going to. It's good. Well, y'all listen to these, and like I said, next Christmas you go out to the store, you probably get them. You know, they sell this kind of stuff around Christmas time. More, you know, they trying to sell every kind of Christmas song on Christmas time, and this be the first one you should get, and listen to it every year like I do. So thank you kindly for listening, and let's let old Tennessee Ernie Ford tell you the rest of it here. Rest of the story, like Paul Harvey is what I was doing.
Away up north in Wonderland, there lives a jolly little man. He's Jingle-O the Brownie. He works for Santa Claus. He shakes the clouds and makes it snow. He plants the Christmas trees that grow. And when he walks, he bounces just like a rubber ball.
Hey.
Jackie, I got a few questions.
Wait, why'd you stop it?
Number one, what the fuck is a brownie?
It's like a magic,
elf?
Yeah, one of those. It's what, why did you stop it?
Why do they call it a brownie? Who calls things elves a brownie anymore?
Some people, like leprechauns, everything else, got its own names. Different people call them different things, different languages or different countries. Why? Just play the song.
He said way up north in Wonderland, which is that where Santa Claus lives? Because
yes,
I thought he lived in North Pole.
Same thing.
There lives a funny little man, jolly little man. A man is a man, a brownie. You wouldn't say, here, look at this funny little man.
Well, there are people.
The leprechaun.
There are people like, I got arms and legs and eyes. I ain't Star Wars.
And also, I don't understand this. So this is a song about, he shakes the clouds and makes it snow.
Yep, that's what
it is. And then he plants the Christmas trees that grow.
I can hear it, too.
And then he when he walks, he bounces like a rubber ball. What does that have to do with anything? That is poor construction.
You don't even.
That is poor planning of your essay
listen,
song.
Listen to it before you start tearing it down like I know you're going to do anyway. You just cut it off in the middle. It may be going somewhere. It could be you don't listen to another story. You don't even know what it is, and you stop it. Just you said you was going to play it. You put it on the computer, said you play it for me. Just play it.
Another thing is, what? When you're trying to find this song, and you, for Jackie, who made me let him play it.
Yep. Well, evidently
you start
not. Because
you're Googling.
You're not playing it.
Tennessee Brownies. I didn't even think that now I'm on a watch list, probably. Somebody's probably breaking down the door to Granny's basement as we speak.
Tennessee Armed Ford is Jingle-O Brownie.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
Building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
He works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day. Now Jingle-O, he makes a trip each day in his red rocket ship around the world to see if you're being good or bad. He's got a great big magic eye that watches you from in the sky, and when he sees you acting mean, poor Jingle-O is sad.
What the fuck?
Hey.
He's got a magic eye that he watches all the children with?
He's got, like Santa Claus can't look at all the children all the time. That's Jingle-O.
What does that even mean?
Watches where you good or bad.
What does a rocket ship have to do with it?
He don't have a sleigh like Santa Claus.
I don't understand. He makes it snow, makes the Christmas trees grow. Then it said he builds all the toys.
He does.
And then he flies a rocket ship around and spies on all the kids. And if a kid is bad, he doesn't even swoop down Jack Bauer style and take him out or torture him. What he does is he just gets sad about it.
What?
That's the worst use of illegal surveillance I've ever heard of.
All right.
I want to get bummed out. I'm just going to spy on everybody being an asshole.
Hey.
Well, yeah, you're going to get bummed out.
It ain't just play. You're putting too much thought into all this. It's
no,
just a
no.
Good,
what? I am putting the correct amount of thought.
Oh, hell.
The people who
just
didn't put any thought into it, it's whoever the fuck wrote Jingle-O.
Hey, watch your mouth. You don't need to. I just.
The brownie.
You won't even give it a chance. You said you'd play the damn thing and you won't play it. Just play the song. Just let me hear it all the way through.
Okay.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
Building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
He works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day. He feeds the reindeer sugar flakes and bakes old Santa chocolate cakes. He lights up all the Christmas trees and rings the Christmas bells. He is a busy little man, a-watching over Wonderland. For Jingle-O the Brownie is king of all the elves.
Hey!
King of the elves?
Play the song!
Okay, I gotta say, that threw me for a loop that Jingle-O is king of all the elves, because we are hopefully nearly finished with this song, and I still don't have a clear grasp of who Jingle-O the Brownie is as a person. Now I find out he's king of the elves. I think I would lead with that, songwriter. I mean, king of the elves sounds more important than baking fucking cakes for fat-ass Santa Claus.
Hey, he does all that stuff.
What does Santa Claus do? Hey, Jingle-O the Brownie, king, elf, and elf king, who can drive a rocket ship and has a magic eye and feels empathy towards misbehaving children, and he feeds the reindeer, and he bakes. He can bake. What does Santa Claus do? He makes all the toys. He lights up the trees. He makes the trees grow. He makes it snow.
Santa
controls the weather.
Santa Claus is, it don't matter what kind of elf, king, whatever. He happens to be king, and he's the best elf. And he's the best one because he does all these things. Santa Claus is still high in the ranks. They work for him. They work for, it don't matter if you're king, president, elf, it don't matter. You still do what Santa Claus tell you. And I tell you what Santa Claus does. He, one night, you know how going to every damn house in one night and giving presents. That's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work.
Yep.
I'll give you that.
Yeah, it is. That's what his job is.
But it sounds to me like, at the least, I'm not saying Santa doesn't have to do a lot on that one night, but I'm saying for the rest of the year, when Jingle-O is working his hands to the bone, Santa Claus could at least hire some temps. These seem like jobs that don't have a lot to do with each other.
What?
Like that when maybe some other people left, retired, whatever. Oh. Jingle-O said, hey, Jingle-O, you can do the thing where you feed the reindeer the flakes, right? And they go, I guess. Hell, why don't we hire somebody else to do that? You know, budgets, things are tight. So Jingle-O winds up, hey, Jingle-O, can you drive a rocket ship? Like, no. Well, we're gonna train you on
it.
You go over there and talk to Edith. She's retiring at the end of the month. She's got 2 hours this afternoon training you on flying a rocket ship. You're going to need that rocket ship because you're going to be conducting surveillance with the magic eye in the sky. You're going to look at all the kids. Now, listen, this is very important.
It's his magic eye. It's his eye already. He didn't get the eye through moving up the ladder. He already had the magic eye. He does all this because he's magical. He's an elf. He's the king of the elves. He's the most magical. Well,
is he the only elf? Because if there were other elves, it seems like they'd be taking some of this off his plate.
You know how much stuff they goes on North Pole, Winter Wonderland, whatever it is.
Yeah, I think I got a pretty good idea because they mentioned every single one of them in this song.
Now, this is what the King Jingle-O does, Brownie Elf. He does all this stuff for Santa Claus. There's other elves doing everything that needs to be, you know, shoveling doorways, whatever needs to be done, North Pole elves doing it. He's in charge of them. He's the king of them. And it's like, if they can't do a job right, I'm going to do it myself. And he's magic. He can do all this stuff. He cares.
Maybe king of the elves is sort of honorary title, like mayor of Hollywood. Like, maybe he's like Johnny Grant.
I don't know. Will you just play the damn song? You said he's going to play the song. Play the song.
Okay.
Jingle-O, jingle-O, jingle-O the brownie-o, building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh. Jingle-O, jingle-O, jingle-O the brownie-o, he works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day.
Quit stopping it, just...
That's the end of the song.
What?
That's the end of it. It ended. That's not my fault.
I didn't say
blame Tennessee Ernie Ford.
It's not. It's your fault that you kept stopping it over and over again, and they can't even listen to the whole song.
I don't believe that bullshit in there about how he sings a happy song and dreams of Christmas Day. That sounds like propaganda to me.
What do you mean
that
propaganda?
Sounds like anti-union propaganda. Oh, they put, hell. Oh, look how happy they love the work these elves do. Some Harry Potter shit in there.
It's not Harry Potter's. It's Santa Claus.
It's close enough. What's the difference between a damn Dobby and a damn brownie?
I don't know.
Are there brownies in Harry Potter's?
I don't know.
Pluralizing everything now.
I don't know all that Harry Potter's. I've seen some of that and I don't understand it all.
I don't understand. First of all, I'm exhausted listening to this.
Oh, hell.
It's like that woman. Like
you didn't even listen to it. You're exhausted because you run your damn mouth through the whole thing. That's why you're exhausted.
It's like they, what could we write? Let's write a song about an elf. Okay.
Well, it's Christmas time. That's when you sing about elves.
What does the elf do? Well, he helps out Santa Claus. Oh, well, what all would he do? Let's just make a list. Well, he'd make all the toys, yeah. Or what if he shakes the clouds and makes it snow? Okay. What if he's got a rocket ship and a magic eye? Did you just do LSD for the first time last night?
It rhymes.
I did.
It rhymes. That's rocket how you ship. Write.
It's then he's in the kitchen baking a chocolate cake, and then he's king of the elves. That is just a list of things that rhyme, which is, granted, how you make a song.
Are you finished?
Yes. So thanks, everybody. Thanks for listening to the Red State Update podcast.
No, I was going to play two songs. I don't even know if it's worth it now because you're going to run your mouth over the whole damn thing.
So what is the other song you going to play?
Klinker. Klinker is two songs. I told everybody on here. People ask me, they say, we like what you like on Christmas, Jackie. Can you tell us some more? And all I try to do is tell people, and you sit here and run your mouth through it. Just let me play the songs for people. Trying to start new Christmas tradition. Like I said, everybody loves Tennessee Ford. Everyone out there likes that. And maybe didn't know where he did these songs too.
He did other Christmas songs, but these two.
These are my two favorites.
Jingle-O the Brownie and
Klinker.
Well, let's hear Klinker.
Little Klinker was a pup as Santa's helper. He grew up with funny ears, one black, one brown. When one stood up, the other flopped down. One Christmas, Santa Claus forgot before he slept to set his clock. Now what would happen if Saint Nick did not awake to start his trip? But suddenly came Klinker, barking as he ran. At Santa's door, he barked still more. With one big rup, Klinker woke him up. In Santa's sleigh this year you'll see our Klinker proud as he can be. Each Christmas time, don't fear one bit, Klinker will wake up Saint Nick.
Oh, little Klinker was a pup as Santa's helper. He grew up with funny ears,
one black,
one brown.
When one stood up, the other flopped down.
One Christmas Santa Claus forgot before he slept to set his clock.
Now what would happen if Saint Nick did not awake to start his trip?
But suddenly here came Klinker, barking as he ran.
At Santa's door, he barked still more.
With one big rup,
Klinker woke him up.
In Santa's sleigh this year you'll see our Klinker proud as he can be. Each Christmas time, don't fear one bit, Klinker will wake up Saint Nick.
Little Klinker, one stood up, one fell down.
Is that the whole song? Is that it?
You didn't stop that when you let that play all the way through.
I was waiting for something to happen in it.
What do you mean something to happen? Little Klinker bark woke him up.
That's all that happens. That's the only thing that happens in the song.
What's supposed to happen in a song?
I don't know. Half, they really had to stretch that out.
Oh, hell, you didn't.
Half of it's about his ears.
The other one had too much. This one ain't got enough.
Yes, that's exactly right. The other one had way too much. Listen, Jingle-O works his ass off day in and day out. He's got a song that can barely contain the multitude of duties he does. And this fucking dog,
hey,
barks
your mouth
at Santa Claus to wake up, probably just so he can get his ass fed in the morning for breakfast time.
No, it was Christmas. It was Santa's day. Santa, his job, the most important job of all year.
Yes. If I worked one day a year, I'd remember to set my fucking clock.
All right, watch your mouth. Maybe it broke or something. I don't know.
Where's Mrs. Claus?
I don't know.
Where's she in all this?
Can't sleep watching TV. I don't know. It ain't about Mrs. Claus.
Oh, was today the day you're supposed to get up early, honey? I'm sorry.
Well, she, like I said, watching something got distracted, whatever. It don't matter what she was doing.
So the dog barks at Santa Claus, wakes him up.
Yes.
Gets a whole song. They can't even feel like they have to repeat everything. Halfway through, they just start the song over with a chorus. And they leave in the part about his ears. What's his ears got to do with it?
It's funny. The ear up and the ear down. That's what you...
Hey, guys, I think I got something pretty good here. What if Santa Claus overslept and his dog wakes him up? Oh, that's good. And then what? No, that's it. Just write that up for me.
Being smart.
Write that up for me. I'm Tennessee Ernie Ford. I tell you what, guys, I come in here. I want a song about a dog that wakes Santa Claus up, and I want that
finished.
All right.
Before we get to the studio. And then also I want a song about an elf who drives a rocket, bakes a cake, makes it snow, watches little children. What do you mean watches? I said he watches the little children. I'm Tennessee Artie Ford.
All right, Edie, wasn't nothing like it. You don't know anything what he's like.
No, I don't, and neither does anyone else.
He wanted to put out Lil Sean Christmas song for children, and you going to run him down for that, trying to do something for children that nice, that they enjoy, makes them laugh on Christmas, fills children's hearts with joy, listen to Tennessee Artie Ford sing about Jingle-O and Klinker. And you got to run it down.
Lil Klinker. Why is he named Klinker?
It's a funny name. It's little, come here, Klinker. One ears up, one's down. It's funny little dog. And you go.
He gets a ride in the sleigh for waking Santa Claus up with one big gruff. And Jingle-O the Brownie is going to fucking lose it.
Hey, watch your mouth.
He's going to be workplace violence.
Listen.
He's watching Santa Claus fly away like, dog woke me up. He gets to ride in the sleigh. And Jingle-O makes it fucking snow.
All right, watch your mouth. I ain't going to listen to that. Jingle-O is an elf, got magical powers, can do anything he wants up there. Helping out with Santa. The dog is just a dog. Dog can't do nothing but bark and chew fleas or whatever else. Dogs don't
work. That's the sequel, Klinker 2. Klinker chewed the fleas on his skin all day and laid around.
Enough.
Santa Claus said, Klinker,
you just
let's go for a ride in the sleigh. Look at your ears.
You just a Scrooge is all you are. Run down Christmas, run down Tennessee Artie Ford. Run down dogs, too, as far as I'm concerned.
Dogs are a good alarm clock. Jingle-O and Klinker. Why did they never make that Rankin Bass special? Because one of them would have been 2 weeks long, and the other one would be over in 30 seconds.
All right.
Here's the Klinker special.
Okay, enough.
We now return to the Little Klinker Christmas Special. Arf, arf! Huh? What? Oh! The end!
Just run. Are you done running it down?
Yeah.
That's enough. I ain't got any more time to talk about anything because you had to run down. I hope y'all out there listening ask me to turn you on to listen to all this, turn the radio on, listen to all this new Christmas, and that's what this is. That's Little Klinker and Jingle-O, the Brownie. Please go out, get them songs on the computer, get them in the store, wherever you get it now, and listen to it. Without him running his mouth and stopping it, you might actually enjoy it.
So that's Episode 112 of the Red State Update podcast.
There's a lot of stuff going on in the news we won't talk about, and you had to run your mouth over Tennessee Artie Ford.
We haven't even talked about North Korea, Cuba, immigration. Did we ever even talk about Jeb Bush? We didn't talk about that. The Nazis and Social Security. Maybe all this will come up on our next podcast, Jackie.
I don't know. I won't play any songs on that one. I'll be sure not to do that.
So thanks, everybody. Hope you had a Merry Christmas.
Yep, it's last Christmas. New Year's Eve, come on out. See Bill Baronut talking Christmas gift. Tone of Christmas.
Jackie, I guess I'll see you next year.
Yeah, I reckon I will.
2015.
Yep.
We outwitted them again.
I guess so, yeah. I don't know what that means, but...
Me either.
I don't know what outwitted nothing. Yeah.
Should we play out with Jingle-O?
Will you play it all the way through?
Yeah, because if people want to turn it off, then it's over. Listen, folks, this is it. We're not going to do anything else. So feel free to turn it off. Or just jam along with Jingle-O.
Just if you listen
Jingle-O.
Jingle-O the Brownie. It's a good
classic
Christmas song.
Away up north in Wonderland, there lives a jolly little man. He's Jingle-O the Brownie. He works for Santa Claus. He shakes the clouds and makes it snow. He plants the Christmas trees that grow. And when he walks, he bounces just like a rubber ball.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
Building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
He works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day. Now Jingle-O, he makes a trip each day in his red rocket ship around the world to see if you're being good or bad. He's got a great big magic eye that watches you from in the sky. And when he sees you acting mean, poor Jingle-O is sad.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
Building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O.
He works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day. He feeds the reindeer sugar flakes and bakes old Santa chocolate cakes. He lights up all the Christmas trees and rings the Christmas bells. He is a busy little man, a-watching over Wonderland. For Jingle-O the Brownie is king of all the elves.
Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O. Building toys for girls and boys to fill old Santa's sleigh. Jingle-O, Jingle-O, Jingle-O the Brownie-O. He works and sings a jolly song and dreams of Christmas Day.